Where to begin? Where to begin? How about once upon a time? Nah. How many times have you heard that to begin a story? Why don't we just go back to the day things took a turn for the worse? If you want to hear the story, you can read along with me in your book. You'll know it's time to turn the page when you hear this sound. Let's begin now. In the town of Oaky Oaks, Chicken Little was ringing the school bell.
The sky is falling! The sky is falling!
He described a piece of sky that was shaped like a stop sign.
It looks like a stop sign?
Yes! And it hit me on the head!
At first, the crowd panicked. Then his father, Buck Cluck, stopped them.
It's okay, everyone. It was just an acorn that hit my son. A little acorn.
No, Dad, no.
A year later, everyone was still laughing at Chicken Little. There was even talk of making a movie about it. As Buck drove his son to the school bus, he repeated some earlier advice.
Remember how I told you it would be better for you just to lay low, don't call attention to yourself, right?
Chicken Little tried, but it was no use. He missed the bus and chased it through town. He lost his pants. At school, he shook up a soda bottle and used it to launch himself through a window, then got trapped inside his locker. Meanwhile, class was starting. Mr. Wolensworth called the roll. Foxy Loxy, Goosey Lucy, and Chicken Little's friends, Abby Mallard, Runt of the Litter, and Fish Out of Water. Just one student was missing.
Chicken Little.
Toddy again.
In gym class, Chicken Little told Abby about his morning.
But you know, that's not going to get me down. All I need is a chance to do something great to make everyone forget the whole sky falling thing once and for all.
Abby wasn't so sure. She thought Chicken Little should ask why his dad didn't stand up for him when he said the sky fell.
Here's the solution. You and your dad talking. Closure.
Closure?
Talking about something until it's resolved.
Suddenly, a ball came flying at them and knocked Abby down. Foxy Loxy laughed. Chicken Little didn't think it was funny.
That does it.
He marched up to Foxy and started to grab her. Instead, Foxy's sidekick, Goosey Lucy, grabbed Chicken Little and slung him against the wall, setting off the fire alarm. And who got the blame? Chicken Little, of course. He was called to the principal's office, along with his dad. Afterward, Buck listened as Chicken Little described his plan.
What if I joined the baseball team? Dad, you were such a big star in high school, you know? I figured, hey, you could give me some pointers.
Buck shook his head sadly.
Maybe baseball isn't exactly your thing, you know. Have you considered the chess team?
That night, Chicken Little gazed at the stars, wishing he could put things right.
Come on. All I need is a chance.
Chicken Little signed up for the baseball team, the Acorns, but it didn't go well. He sat on the bench, and the star was Foxy Loxy. When the big game rolled around, he was still on the bench. Late in the game, the Acorns needed a hit to tie the score, and the only batter left was Chicken Little. The crowd groaned. He looked up in the stands at his father.
I won't embarrass you, Dad. Not this time.
Chicken Little swung at the first pitch and missed badly.
Strike one?
And again.
Strike two?
On the third pitch, he closed his eyes and hit the ball. Buck cheered, then yelled advice when he saw his son take off in the wrong direction.
No, no, not that way! Run the other way!
Chicken Little turned and headed back toward first. The runner scored, tying the game. When a cow outfielder fumbled the ball, Chicken Little headed for second, then third. Buck cheered him on.
Yes!
Then the crowd gasped. Chicken Little was heading for home. Foxy ran beside him.
You're never gonna make it.
Meanwhile, the ball was stuck on the cow's horn. So the outfielders picked up the cow and raced to the plate. Chicken Little slid. The cow tagged him. The umpire signaled, "You're out!" But when the umpire brushed off the plate, Chicken Little's toe was touching it.
Safe! The runner is safe!
Buck raced onto the field.
We won! We won! That's my boy out there!
That night, Buck sat with his son.
I guess that puts the whole sky is falling incident behind us once and for all. Hey, kiddo.
You bet, Dad. Unless you think we need closure?
Closure? It's closed. Good night, Ace.
After Buck left, Chicken Little gazed at the stars. One got bigger and bigger, then flew right through the window and knocked him to the floor. It could only mean one thing.
A piece of the sky? Shaped like a stop sign? Not again!
Chicken Little called his friends and showed it to them. It was actually an electronic panel that took on the look of its surroundings, making it appear invisible. Abby examined it.
Okay, let me guess. You haven't told your dad yet.
Abby, please. This is exactly what fell on me the first time. There's no way I'm bringing this up again with him.
Fish noticed a red button on the panel. He pushed it, and the panel rose into the air. Fish hopped on and went sipping out the window. Runt, Abby, and Chicken Little went racing downstairs to follow, and Buck saw them.
Wait, whoa, son, where's the fire here?
Abby stopped.
Chicken Little has something to tell you.
But Chicken Little wasn't ready to discuss it.
Gotta go, Dad, bye.
They chased the panel across town to the baseball field, where it spun faster and faster. Suddenly, the field was bathed in bright light, and a spaceship appeared. A hatch opened. Two mechanical creatures emerged. Runt stared.
Oh, poor Fish, he's gone! Gone, man!
Not yet!
Abby pointed to the top of the ship. There, waving excitedly, was Fish. When the creatures walked away into the woods, the three friends sneaked into the ship. Chicken Little noticed a little alien with a single eye. He winked, and the alien winked back. Then, remembering Fish, he hurried off. The little alien followed. The friends rounded a corner and found a screen showing Fish's skeleton. Fish stepped out from behind him. He was fine. Fish showed them what he had found, a map of the planets, with all the other planets crossed out except for Earth, which was circled in red. Chicken Little gulped.
We're next.
They raced toward the exit, but their way was blocked by the two mechanical creatures, which had returned to their ship. The friends darted by them, finally managing to squeeze through the hatch. Runt brought up the rear, getting stuck for a minute.
I'm sorry. Tension makes me bloat.
They hurried away with the creatures in pursuit. Right behind them was the little alien, trying to keep up. The creatures chased them into the woods, through a cornfield, and finally toward town. Abby yelled,
"The school bell! We've got to ring the school bell to warn everyone! Hurry!
When they reached the school, the door was locked. But Chicken Little noticed a vending machine.
I need a soda.
He shook the bottle and rocketed himself up to the bell tower. Chicken Little reached for the bell, then remembered the last time he had rung it. Did he really want to go through that again? Then he saw the two creatures going after his friends. He grabbed the bell rope and pulled. The creatures covered their ears and ran off. Meanwhile, a crowd of people advanced on the bell tower.
Chicken Little, you better have a good explanation for this.
He told them about the spaceship.
Follow me! Come on, hurry!
Chicken Chicken Little and his friends led them to the ball field, where the creatures had started the ship's engines. He yelled to the crowd.
Come on, if you don't hurry up, you're gonna miss it.
A moment later, the crowd reached the field. The ship was gone, and there was nothing to see. Someone grumbled.
No, it's the acorn thing all over again.
Abby spoke up.
No, wait, there were aliens.
Chicken Little turned to his father.
Dad! Dad! I'm not making this up. You gotta believe me this time.
Buck sighed.
No, son. I don't.
The crowd wandered off, and Chicken Little headed home. He was all alone. Or was he? The bushes parted, and the little alien popped out. Seeing Chicken Little, he followed. Miles above in the spaceship, the two creatures realized that the little alien wasn't on the ship. They sent out a distress call. When Chicken Little got home, Abby and the others were waiting.
If there was ever a time to talk to your dad, it's now.
It's too late for that.
He turned away, and there behind him was the little alien. Chicken Little winked like before. Instead of winking back, the alien started to wail. Runt stared.
What is that thing?
The alien babbled hysterically. To their amazement, Fish translated. They learned that the alien was from the spaceship and had been left behind. Suddenly, the ground began to shake, and spaceships filled the sky. Chicken Little noticed the alien making happy sounds.
Those are your parents? And they brought the Galactic Armada?
The alien took off toward the ship, running right into traffic. Chicken Little yelled,
"Watch out for the kid! Don't hit him!"
The town was in a panic. People tried to run, but an army of mechanical creatures blocked the way. When Foxy threw a rock at one of them, she was zapped by a light beam and disappeared. Buck found Chicken Little and grabbed him.
We gotta get out of here. Come on.
Chicken Little tried to pull away, and Abby spoke up.
Will you two stop messing around and deal with the problem?
Chicken Little faced his father.
You're never there for me. You've been ashamed of me ever since the acorn thing happened.
You're right. But you need to know that I love you, no matter what. And I'm sorry if I ever made you feel like that was something you had to earn.
Chicken Little smiled and hugged his dad. Then they snapped back into action. The alien pointed. Chicken Little saw a ship over Town Hall.
Oh, is that your parents?
Chicken Little told Buck his plan.
All we have to do is duck and weave through traffic and make our way through Town Square while avoiding the death rays from those alien robots. Then we get to Town Hall, climb up to the highest point of the roof, and give the kid back to its parents.
Yeah!
Buck grabbed the little alien, and they raced into the crowd. When they reached Town Hall, a robot blocked their path. Buck turned to Chicken Little.
Okay, son, now what?
Just then, Abby, Runt, and Fish sped by in a fire truck, grabbing their friends just before the robot blasted them. The truck crashed into Town Hall, and Chicken Little jumped out along with Buck. Taking the alien, they charged up to the roof. Chicken Little climbed to the top, held out the alien.
Here's your kid! Look over here!
A green beam shot out. Chicken Little, Buck, and the alien disappeared. They reappeared inside the ship. A voice boomed.
Release the child!
Buck immediately let go, and the alien scampered off. The big voice continued.
You have violated Intergalactic Law 90210, a charge punishable by immediate particle disintegration.
A moment later, a softer voice spoke.
Melvin, honey, turn off your big voice. Turn it off.
Yes, dear.
The voices were Melvin and Tina, the aliens' parents. Tina explained that on vacations, they stopped here every year.
I mean, where else would we have picked our acorns?
They apologized for the full-scale invasion and then used their beams to restore the town and everyone who had disappeared. As the aliens prepared to leave, a panel fell off their ship, and it was shaped like a stop sign. Tina sighed.
There goes that panel again. Seriously, honey, someday it's going to hit somebody on the head.
The ship soared off into the sky. A year later, in the movie version, Chicken Little spoke.
Though at times it may feel like the sky is falling around you, never give up.
When the movie ended, Buck proudly lifted up his son, and the audience cheered. For once, Chicken Little was the biggest guy in town.